I'm Nishu and I'm going to explain you all again an important topic, and that topic is related to female reproductive system, and the system which I'm going to explain today is your menstrual cycle. This is an exclusive process which only occurs among the females. Till yet children, we have discussed the process of gametogenesis, where how the sperms were developing inside the male reproductive system by the process of spermatogenesis. And we have also discussed the process of development of ovum inside the female reproductive system by the process oogenesis. Now, the process of oogenesis, where you have studied that how the ovum is being developed inside the female body before the birth and after attaining puberty till the menopause. Children, this whole cycle depends upon this menstrual cycle, that whether the zygote formation is going to take place or not. So this zygote formation is dependent on the process of menstrual cycle. Now children, what is menstrual cycle? This menstrual cycle is a process which is a cyclic process. It's repeating. The whole cycle will be repeating throughout the reproductive life among the females. Hence, it is called as a cyclic change. Now children, this menstrual cycle is a cyclic change which is related to the process of ovulation. And it is also related to the secretion of different type of hormones among the females of different type of living organisms. Children, now let us know that what is your menstrual cycle. Children, actually this process is a process of bleeding which occurs among the females. Now, let us discuss the definition that what is menstruation. This menstruation is a process of bleeding through vagina due to breakage of endometrium, which is called as menstruation. Now children, this menstruation is a process of bleeding through the body part of female's vagina, which is the last part of the female reproductive tract. Now, the breakage. How? Because of breakage of endometrium. Now children, we have discussed the structure of whole reproductive system of females, where we have studied the structure of ovary, fallopian tube, uterus, cervix, vagina. All these parts are playing very important role. Basically, in the process of menstrual cycle, the parts vagina is involved, and your endometrium layer, the inner lining of the uterus, is involved. Uterus plays very important role in the process of menstrual cycle. Children, I told you all that inside the uterus, we have discussed it, that there are three layers. The outer layer is the perimetrium, the middle layer is the myometrium, and the inner layer is the endometrium. Children, this endometrium becomes thick inside the uterus of every female every month. Now, what do you mean by every month? I'll be discussing in the later part with the description of this topic. Now, children, this endometrium, which is the inner lining of the uterus, this lining breaks. And because of this breaking, your menstrual cycle occurs. So that is why, what is menstrual? This menstrual is a process of bleeding through vagina due to breakage of endometrium, and the process is termed as menstruation. So the endometrium layer of the uterus is getting break, and due to which your bleeding occurs and it is released out through the female reproductive tract. So the release of the waste, release of the blood through the reproductive tract is called as menstrual. Now children, what is endometrium? I told you all that endometrium is inner wall of uterine membrane. It is the inner wall of your uterine membrane. Now let us know that what happens and why the bleeding occurs. Now children, this uterus and the endometrium lining, which is present, the inside, which is the inner lining of the uterus, is highly supplied with blood vessels. And within the blood vessels, obviously blood is flowing. So when this endometrium breaks, when the lining of the endometrium breaks, obviously the blood vessels are also going to be harmed. So this blood vessels also get ruptures. And when the blood vessel ruptures, the blood oozes out of the vessels, and blood is a waste material now, and that waste material the body cannot keep, and that blood is released out in form of bleeding through the reproductive tract, through the external genitalia part of the female reproductive system. So children, this endometrium gets breaked, the blood vessels get ruptured, and excessive blood flows takes place, and this blood is released out, it is excluded out through the external genitalia part of the female reproductive system, and this process is called as menstrual.
Formation of zygote will take place inside the fallopian tube, but the
development of the child will be taking place inside the fetus. So your uterus also gets prepared, and this preparation is how it is in form of endometrium layer gets thickened. The endometrium becomes thick, and because of that thickness inside the layer of endometrium, children, in between your myometrium and your endometrium, children, if suppose this is your uterus part and this is your endometrium and this is your myometrium, so here a large number of blood vessels will develop. So this endometrium layer becomes thickened, and in this layer a large number of blood vessels gets developed, and this preparation is why, this preparation is so that if the fertilization occurs, then the uterus can hold the zygote to develop it into embryo and fetus. But if sperm is not there, fertilization is not taking place, then what will happen? The ovum inside the fallopian tube will destroy. And what will happen to this endometrium? This endometrium will also get damaged. It will also get ruptured because the endometrium is not required now. That preparation is not required now. Hence, the endometrium layer along with the ovum, both of them gets degenerated. Now children, this degenerated, this ruptured endometrium, it is not having any role. It is a waste product, and along with this endometrium, this blood vessels also get ruptured, and this blood vessels, through these blood vessels, your blood is released out through the external genitalia, part of the female reproductive system, and this process is called as menstrual cycle, menstruation. Children, hope you have understood that what is menstrual and how the endometrium is playing role. So now let us, children, move ahead to the next question, that what causes menstrual flow, that what happens that menstrual occurs among the females. Now children, I will be discussing the whole process point by point. Now the first point says that an egg is released from either of the ovaries every 28 days. Now you know that your female reproductive system is having a pair of ovary, and in each ovary ovum formation takes place. Now children, in each of the ovary, after every 28 days one ovum gets mature and it is released into the fallopian tube by the process of ovulation. So hence, now to the second point, an unfertilized egg is alive for 24 hours after ovulation. What do you mean by this point? It means that after every 28 days when one ovum is being released into the fallopian tube, now that ovum is unfertilized. It means that sperm and ovum fusion has not taken place. So that ovum is still waiting within the fallopian tube for the sperm to get fertilized. So there, in that condition, in the fallopian tube, this unfertilized ovum survives only for 24 hours after ovulation process. After this 24 hours, if sperm is available to the ovum, then fertilization process will take place and zygote formation takes. Now, if sperm is not there, then what happens? We will be studying in this process. Now, uterus prepares to receive the fetus. Endometrium gets thickened. Now, I told you that during the ovulation process, when the mature ovum is being released into the fallopian tube, during that process simultaneously, the uterus also gets prepared, and the preparation is in form of formation of a large blood vessels in the lining of the endometrium, which makes the endometrium wall thickened. Now children, let's see that what happens. Now children, what happens when the endometrium gets thickened? Uterus waits for zygote But if fertilization does not occurs, then no zygote is formed. Now I told you all that simultaneously along with the ovulation, uterus also gets prepared by thickening the endometrium, and the mature ovum is waiting inside the fallopian tube for the sperm to get fertilized. But if sperm is not there, then what will happen? Fertilization will not take place. And if fertilization is not taking place, then no zygote is formed. You know that when sperm and ovum gets fused, zygote is formed. And when there is no availability of sperm, ovum is alone, then zygote will not be not formed. So if fertilization is not taking place, zygote formation will also not take place. It means pregnancy will not persist. Now children, what will be the result if fertilization is not taking place? Then inside the uterus, the endometrium layer will get breakdown, and along with the breakdown of the endometrium, the thickened blood vessels which are formed, that blood vessels will also get ruptured. And due to the rupture of blood vessels and the endometrium tissue, the blood will come out through vagina or the external genitalia part of the females. And this process is called menstrual flow. Now children, you might have seen many of the females experiencing back pain or lower abdomen pain during the cycles. Now children, what such happens that the females experiences such type of pain? Now let us come to that point. We have discussed a lot about this, that the uterus is having the inner lining endometrium. Children, this whole structure is muscular. They are made up of muscles. And children, when the muscles gets contracted, the muscles which are present within the uterus parts, when that muscles get contract, and why this contraction occurs? This contraction occurs so that when the blood vessels get ruptured, the blood can easily ooze out of the vessel and they can allow the blood to flow out through the external genitalia part. That is why children, the female experiences sometimes lower abdomen pain or lower back pain. So this is the reason behind the pain. Hope children, till yet this topic is clear to you all. I'll be discussing that how the secretion of hormones are affecting the menstrual cycle. Till thank you.